Welcome back to the Member 2 Sport and Wellness Center, the Member 2 Mi'kmaq Nation, for the 2024 Nova Scotia Under 15 AAA Female Hockey Championship Tournament. Our final round robin matchup of the two-day round robin portion of the tournament features the Metro East Inferno and the Quad County Whitecaps. The Inferno have a slim chance of making tomorrow's championship game. They'd have to really narrow the plus-minus gap. With a win, they would have an identical 2-1-1 record to the Metro West Force Warriors. But again, the plus minus, they have to make up some ground. So, and they're up against the 1-2 Quad County Whitecaps, who are out of contention for tomorrow's championship game. Good tournament for them. They gave the Warriors, or pardon me, the undefeated Citadels, their best test of the tournament, losing 4-3 in overtime. And both these teams have some dynamic scores leading the way for the Whitecaps, at least in this tournament. Flora Gale McNeil, 5 goals, 2 this morning, including a Michigander. And she has the most in the tournament thus far, again with 5 after 3 games. Leading the way, Danica Joseph for the Inferno with 3 goals after 3 games. And of course, the Whitecaps have the regular seeding leading scorer in Summer McLean. The starting goaltenders for this one, Lily Williams for the Inferno, and getting her first nod of the tournament for the Whitecaps. Between the pipes is Tessa McKinnon. And we're underway here. Whitecaps in there, white and teal. The Inferno in their sharp-looking blue, golden, orange. Shot, they score! Right off the bat, Joseph. And McKinnon looks skyward, her first test. McKinnon, who again, first action of the tournament. No doubt a little bit of jitters. She'll be okay, she'll settle in here. 32 seconds in, the Joseph goal. That's a big one for the Inferno to start it. Her fourth of the tournament, Danica Joseph. Again at the 32 second mark, Joseph. The first shot of the game for either side. Now off the face-off. Back out to neutral ice. Poirier now. Poirier. Back to the point, been intercepted. And the Whitecaps now in on the forecheck. Violet McDonald chasing after it. Kept in at the point. McDonald puts it deep. Out there with Cleary, also joining them, Sponigal. Steered aside by Williams. Backhander deflects to the corner. McNeil. McCormick. It's spun around. Here's McCarthy. Chipped it out of the zone. But there to pick it up and dump it right back in is Sponigal. Inferno trying to catch the Whitecaps on a change. That didn't work. Now Cormier. Cormier dumps it in. And back to collect it is Lucy Ryan. Centering pass. Bouncy puck, Ryan. Inferno take over. Shot from the point, that's deflected to the corner by Cormier. Dribbled through the crease, picked up by London. Shot deflected wide off the stick of Cannon. And now over to pick up the puck. Carry it out, McCackrum, but she has to take it away. Centering pass, Cannon, she scores! So a quick start here for the Inferno. Cannon at 2:58 to make it 2-0. Her first of the tournament. Whitecaps now have to regroup down early. Connolly. They certainly have the firepower to do it. It is Leanna Cannon. Gabrielle London with the helper. Inferno looking for more here. Centering pass, knocked away. Shot from the point, steered aside by McKinnon. McLean, great lead pass right under the tape of Violet McDonald. Steered aside by Williams, and now McCormick. McCormick, weaving her way, nice lead pass there. Shot by LaPierre, deflects wide. Fight Frances McDonald in front of her own net. Knifed away by McKinnon. Up the boards. Banging away at it was Duero. Dumped in by the captain, McInnes. And now in on the forecheck are the Whitecaps. Dumped out. In after McCormick. She's in a battle with Lucy Ryan. That deflects. Trying to center it. Inferno back to the offense here, and they're going to draw a penalty. Delayed call. Still in possession, but taking over there is Flora Gale McNeil. So a big chance now for the Inferno on the power play. Up 2-0 already early. 9:46 remaining in the first. Shot off the side of the net. Kept in by Cormier. That shot over the head of McKinnon. Dumped out. Flora Gale McNeil in after it. Great penalty killer. Again, she has a tournament high. 5 goals. Joseph, she's in early, and that'll be offside as she tried to split the D but got held up. 1:16 remaining in the opening period. Our last round robin, game of the tournament. We've had 10 great showcases of female hockey, under 15 hockey across the province here in Member 2. It'll culminate tomorrow again with our championship team. It'll be the Metro West Force Citadels versus either their sister club, the Warriors, or the Metro East Inferno here in this one, depending on its result. Good start for the Inferno, but again, they're going to need more than a win. They're going to need a strong plus minus showing in this one. Shot off the side of the net on the 2-on-1. Cutliff now. Banged out. Picked up there. And dumped into the zone to make a chase after his Summer McLean. Kept in the zone, McLean. And now on the other side, Poirier. Was off the stick of McCarthy. And dumped in by McLean. And speeding in after it is Veronica Boyle. Kept in McLean. Goes down low. Boyle now after it. Boyle tried to center it for Fike Francis McDonald, who is in there on the forecheck, couldn't come up with it. And now some room for the Inferno, up 2-0. Cormier, oh, just unable to keep it in. Tough luck there for Romar. Dumped in by McDonald. Inferno, though, look to bring it right back out, and they do now. McNeil. Flora Gale McNeil with a head of speed. McNeil off the goal post. That close to her sixth of the tournament. Beautiful move outside the blue line, then brought it in and got a great look at Williams from the slot and ripped it off the goal post. Off the draw. Morrell has to retreat for it. 6:35 remaining in the first. Inferno 2, the Whitecaps no score. Room now, McCaffrey. Laid it off for Richards. Richards tried to drop it back for McNeil. McNeil gets it and puts it in deep. In off the point. Now Richards, Sean Richards looking to center. It hit the back of the net. And that's where the Inferno take over. Out to neutral ice, Dwarrell. Poked into the zone by Richards, but right back out. Now the captain, Danny Ray McInnes. Blocker save by Williams. Boyle in looking for it. Now McInnes. Still in deep. Boyle. Boyle took a bump. Now McLean in there in a battle with the captain, McCormick. And there's going to be a penalty there against McCormick as she got tangled up chasing down Boyle. So a big chance here for the Whitecaps, down 2-0, as they try to cut into the early Inferno lead. It'll be McCormick to the box for 2 minutes or less in the draw to the left of Williams. McLean, oh, just missed on the far side. McInnes, down low. Up on the dash, your rolling puck, McInnes settles it. And now Flora Gale McNeil, McLean. McLean with it, back for McInnes. McNeil, trying to go short side, just missed up on the roof. Good play there by McCarthy to get it out against McInnes. And now McNeil. Flora Gale McNeil in. Already he's hit a goal post. Looking for her sixth goal of the tournament and a great centering pass. But Richards couldn't get any wood on it. Richards. McNeil. McNeil twisting, spinning. Looking for a seam here. Wrist shot. Up high. Williams couldn't corral it. And McNeil head to the bench for a rest. McLean. Dipsy Doodles. McLean rolled off her stick. Back to the point. Dwaron. McCachran. Around the boards. Richards now. Back to the point. Kept in. Good possession here in the zone, but haven't really threatened Williams. Still loose. Connolly. Connolly. Point shot. Richards couldn't corral it. Now in the battle for it. Back to five aside, but still in the inferno zone. It's still in there. Great work by the Whitecaps. Finally out come the inferno. Joseph. And a good defensive play there. Now Cannon, Leanna Cannon. And it goes up into the netting for a face-off. 2:40 remaining in the first. A pair of early goals, the difference. 32 seconds in, Danica Joseph. And then a 2:58 Leanna Cannon. That's the difference, 2-0. Here in member two, and now Fight Francis McDonald dumps it in. Whitecaps after it, trying to get it in front. On the backhand, but that didn't work by Sponigal. Behind McKinnon's net, Romer. Cleary, lead pass. McDonald couldn't catch up with it. Poirier, shot block. Center, knifed away by McKinnon. Saved by McKinnon on the spinorama by Mitchell. She started to settle in. After getting her sea legs early. Battle for it here. Knocked away. 1:15 remaining in the first. Referee telling them to get it moving here. Starting to jar loose now. There it is. And finally, less than 1 minute remaining. Can these Whitecaps get a late one? That just eluded McLean. McLean now, back to her feet. Lead pass for Violet McDonald, who dumps it around the boards. There's McCachran. McCachran. Pins it, looking for some assistance. McLean couldn't get it back to the point. Now a 2-on-1. Cannon, shot and a nice save there by McKinnon. And that was the dangerous London. Big face-off here, 18.1 seconds remaining. Richards will take it against Joseph. It's loose, chipped to the corner. Green now. McNeil, final seconds, trying to get something here late. McNeil, high shot missed on the short side. So good action there in the opening period. Highlighted by a couple of quick early goals by the Inferno. Danica Joseph at 32 seconds. Leanna Cannon at 2:58. And now the Kings will go to the benches for a quick break, and then we'll have our second period of 15 minutes and then a full intermission. And a 20-minute third period. Again, just a reminder, this is our 10th and final round robin matchup over 2 days. The teams, coaches, and supporters will enjoy their league banquet tonight. And then tomorrow at 11 a.m. for all the marbles. A provincial banner on the line. Here at 11 a.m. if you can't make it out, we encourage you, if you're close to the area, drop into the Member 2 Sport Wellness Center to watch all the action. But if not, we know we have some parents, grandparents, friends and family further afield. And you can tune in again with me and Nolan Jessam on the camera for the championship game tomorrow at 11. Now off the draw to start the second. Shot, ooh, and just missed by London. Not sure if McKinnon got a piece of it or not. It's in front, banged ahead, and out. Now McNeil will backtrack. I don't think it'll have the legs for icing. McNeil slowed, so they waved it off. McNeil, Flora Gale now for the Whitecaps. Squirts free. Some room here. Shot blocker saved by Williams. McNeil puts it deep. And now LaPierre. LaPierre gets knocked off the puck, but they're able to get it out. London. Joseph, will she get to it? Tried to get it in front to London. Good defensive work there. Joseph went down, jabbing at the puck. McInnes trying to get it free, the Whitecap captain. 13:45 remain. Referee telling them to get it moving. And free now is Dwarrell. Lead pass. And now McLean. Summer McLean, again, led the league in the regular season, 42 goals, 19 assists for 61 points. Mitchell.
I know somebody's going to get me. It's my dad.
Cross ice.
Or my mother.
Gathering it there. Cutliff. Back the other way, a 3-on-1, McLean. Her shot blocked by Cormier. Sinclair White now, trying to get by Romard. Romard made a good defensive play. Scrum along the boards. Players falling. See if the puck comes free. Cutliff to her feet. And now ripped into the zone by McCormick, the captain. Coming the other way now. Cleary in. Cleary. And able to catch up to her and knock her off the puck. A great recovery by Green. Now McCormick. trying to get through a sea of bodies. McCarthy ends up with it. McCarthy pinned by Fight Frances McDonald in front of Captain McCormick. And she shot it over the crossbar. Racing in to pick it up is Connolly. They cough it up. Josephine. McKinnon to save, and they score on the rebound. London able to put it home. At the 3:31 mark. Off the rebound, able to slide it under McKinnon to make it 3-0. Off the draw. Up the boards, there's London who just scored.
Metro Winston Bruno goal scored by number 7, Gabrielle London.
McCachran now tried to get it back to the point to McKinnis, but it's intercepted. Picked up shot, saved by Williams. Good hard wrist shot there off the stick of Kerry Dwerall. And now will be a face-off to the right of Williams with 11 minutes remaining in the second. Off the draw, McNeil centered it. Richards couldn't get a shot away. Tried to get it back to McNeil. McNeil of the Inferno takes over. Centering pass, but the Inferno end up with it. Poirier in. Puck knocked away from her, now McKinnis. Ahead to McCachern. McCachern. Shot and it's smothered by Williams. Face off to the left of Williams here. In on the draw and the face-off win. Back to the point. Redirect it wide. And then slides out to neutral ice, and that's where it'll be picked up and brought in by Lucy Ryan. And it'll come back into the white cap zone. .10:02 remaining. Inferno 3, the white caps don't score. Right in front, McKinnon made a big save. Kept in at the point. But now the Inferno. Back off in the white caps clear the zone, dump it in deep. Cormier. Coughed up and now McLean. McLean looking to make something happen here. And it's smothered by Williams. She was sharp in her game yesterday. Equally so, not overly tested, but when she has been. So we'll have a face-off to her right, 9:26. Remaining in the second period. Face-off. Back to the point, dumped in. Kept in at the point, now in on the forecheck, Duero. Cleary there as well. Cleary comes up with it. Trying to center it. Parked in front with Sponigal. And now Joseph. Joseph off to the races. Joseph! Oh! What a blistering blast that was! Danica Joseph with her second. No chance for McKinnon on that one. It was a laser beam at the 6:08 mark to make it 4-0. What an individual effort, and the shot was again blistered under the crossbar, glove side. The second of the game for Joseph. She's tied Flora Gale McNeil for first in the tournament with 5 goals. Gabrielle London, Leanna Cannon with the helpers, her line mates. 8:33 remaining in the second. McInnes from the point, hit a leg. White Caps need an answer here. Now Poirier. Poirier centered it. No one there. Back the other way come the White Caps. McNeil. Poirier. And dumped in McNeil. Flora Gale for the White Caps. But it didn't get in deep, so back the other way come the Inferno. McInnes, the captain, long lead pass. Found Violet McDonald. Racing in as well to pick it up there. Good work by Boyle. Veronica Boyle. Violet McDonald now. And she was stripped by Cutliff. Banged out. And now McNeil and LaPierre retreat for it against Summer McLean. Right back out. They didn't want to mess around with McLean in the offensive zone. Romark. And now McLean. McLean with it. Laid it off. Fife, Francis McDonald. Digging away at it. McLean now. McLean trying to muscle in. Fife, Francis McDonald. Battling, now Cleary there. McLean comes away with it. Lifts it over. Shot blocked. As McCarthy gets up gingerly. But now she's back to her feet, and here's Joseph again. Joseph, and she'll draw a penalty here. Muscled down by Connolly. She tried to get in front with one hand on the stick. It's been the Danica Joseph show in this one so far. 2 goals already. And she, her speed has been dangerous from the get-go, challenging the White Cap defense. It's Connolly with the penalty, so a chance now on the power play for the Inferno. Mitchell. Interception, McNeil. Oh, and Williams bailed out her defenders. Flora Gale McNeil had the chance for her 6th of the tournament. But Williams, her best save of the evening. Off the faceoff. Here comes Joseph again. Joseph tried the backhand pass to Cannon. But but it was knocked away by the Whitecap defense. And now McInnes lofts it out. McNeil in on the forecheck on the penalty kill. Joined there by McCachran. But now numbers for the Inferno, but unable to hold up was McCarthy as the captain McCormick sped off. 5:19 remaining in the second, 58 seconds in the Connolly penalty. Off the faceoff. McCormick now. The captain, cross ice. McCarthy brings it in. McCormick. McCormick is free. Rich shot. Glove saved by McKinnon. To keep it 4-0. 4:55 remaining. Off the faceoff. There's McCormick. Saved by McKinnon, the rebound. LaPierre. Off the steal. Oh, and the shot just missed on the glove side. Low from Boyle. She didn't get good wood on it. And now back the other way, Poirier. But she made that move, and McCormick was ahead of the field. So another rush negated by a little bit of anxiousness. And on that move, Poirier had to evade a checker. Scrum in the neutral zone. Squirts free Sinclair White. Behind the net, 4:05 remaining in the second period. Whitecaps would love to get at least one here late in the second, take some momentum to the third. Connolly up ahead. Back the other way. Now Connolly once again. Neutralized, battle for it. Connolly falls, and now fight Frances McDonald gets it to her teammate Morrell. And now Cleary. Cleary takes it wide. Jenna Cleary tried to center it. Back to the point, McInnes. 3:10 remaining in the second period. The Inferno 4, the Whitecaps no score. Trying to start a rally here late in the second. Center, Richards couldn't get a stick on it. That shot, McInnes almost fooled Williams. Richards now. Whitecaps buzzing a bit. Down low. Batted around. Finally, the Inferno bring it out. Cannon. And again, Joseph in early. The Inferno anxious. They know they have to put some more goals on the board as well. Off the draw, Flora Gale McNeil now. She gets knocked down. McCachern now. McCachern. Green now behind her net. deflects to the neutral zone, right to Cutliff. Delayed offside. Cutliff, after tagging up, back in after it. Richards. Kept in McCormick. Now deflects to the neutral zone. Green. Diving. Couple of players go down. Now it's dumped in. Poirier after it. 90 seconds remaining in the second period. Centering pass, bouncy puck, saved by McKinnon. In close quarters against Sinclair White. Here comes McNeil. And a save by Williams, no rebound, with a couple of White Caps buzzing around. 104 remaining in the second period, the Inferno 4. White Caps no score. Maybe a late one here.
Last play in the second period.
McLean's parked in front. Now Joseph watching her. Pinned behind the net, squirts free. That's where Green will pick it up. Tried to lead away London, but that didn't connect, but now London with it. London, a rising shot that missed. Cannon, McLean now, some room for Summer McLean. Lead pass, picked up center for McLean, and she was tied up. Back to collect it is Morrell. McLean with it again. Team had to get onside. Now fight Francis McDonald with the steal. Put it in front, but only an Inferno defender was there. That was Mitchell. As the horn goes to end the second period, we'll have a nice, clean, full intermission in the final 20 minutes. Here in Member 2, your score after 30 minutes of play, the Metro East Inferno 4. The Quad County Whitecaps no score. You're watching the 2024 Nova Scotia Under 15 AAA Female Hockey Championship Tournament from the Member 2 Sport and Wellness Center on the Member 2 Hockey YouTube channel. Welcome back to the Member 2 Sport and Wellness Center, the Member 2 Mi'kmaq Nation for the 2024 Nova Scotia Under 15 AAA Female Hockey Provincial Championship Tournament. Our final period of our final round robin matchup is underway between the Quad County Whitecaps and the Metro East Inferno. The Inferno lead 4-0. On the fresh ice, here they come in the dark blue, gold, and orange. Whitecaps in their white and teal. Cannon now. Centers it, deflects off the goaltender, Tessa McKinnon, who got the start this evening for the Whitecaps and Lily Williams. Oh, and on the fresh ice, she juggled it a little bit, but made sure it stayed out off the stick of Flora Gale McNeil, who has a tournament high 5 goals, but in this one, a pair from Danica Joseph. 2 of the 4 Inferno goals. She also has 5 to lead the tournament. Joseph with a pair. Cannon and London, her line mates, with one apiece. So they've been the difference in this one. Minute into the third. Whitecaps trying to rally. McLean now. And they're going to say she was in before the puck once Violet McDonald touched it. Off the face off the captain, McInnes will go back for it. Danny Ray McInnes. Up the boards, kept in, steered aside by McKinnon. Now Connolly. Actually, that was Dueron, pardon me, number 11. And it ends up an icing call against the Whitecaps. Captain McCormick will take the face off against Mike Francis McDonald. That hit inside of the net. On the McKinnon short side. Now Mitchell. McCarthy dumps it in and the Inferno make chase. And then another puck get held up in the ice and they score. So tough luck there for the Whitecaps. And McCarthy has made it 5-0 here at the 156 mark. So again, behind the net, we saw it in the third period of our previous game. Lucy Ryan went to take the puck and it almost like it was glued to the ice, and she left it behind. The Inferno took over, and McCarthy made no mistake. Poirier with the helper, and now the Inferno looking for more. Again, they're not only need a win, but a plus-minus miracle here. And they're on their way, 5-0. They'll wait till they, tournament organizers, crunch the numbers. We know that the Metro West Force Citadels will be in the championship game. They went undefeated. Oh, and Cannon just missed. McNeil now, Flora Gale McNeil with a head of steam. McNeil saved by Williams. And she'll leave it loose for Green. So the Whitecaps were making a change. Sinclair White, McKinnon the save. .16:38 remaining. Again, we've had five round robin games each of the past 2 days, and what a tremendous showcase of female hockey talent we've seen from this province here in member two. And it'll culminate again tomorrow with a matchup for a provincial title. Boyle now. Whitecaps trying to test Williams. Comes free and we're gonna have a penalty call here. Roughing. And it's gonna be the captain, Danny Ray McInnes. So to the power play go the Inferno. Already with a 5-goal lead, but again, they have to pour it on here. McCormick, the draw win by Fight Francis McDonald. LaPierre, it'll be a glove pass. McCormick now. On the face-off against Fight Francis McDonald, McCormick with the win. Looking to get into the zone, but ripped right back out. That was Connolly. Around the boards, Poirier lost it. Slow start to this advantage, McCarthy. Now Connolly, back the other way, Fight Francis McDonald. She falls, trying to retrieve the puck. And LaPierre kept in at the point. And now the Inferno look to wheel and deal. Poirier with it. In, gets some room, Poirier hit the goal post, rebound. And McCormick's shot didn't get through. Still 40 seconds on the power play, now McCormick. Stick handles her way in. Found. Cannon's weak shot steered aside by McKinnon. Cormier, and there's going to be a penalty call against the Inferno. And it'll be London to the box. So it'll turn into a Whitecap power play. McNeil out to take the draw, 4-on-4. McNeil, shot saved by Williams. McNeil was just being harassed enough there by the defender Sophie Cormier. Face off to the right of Williams. Around the boards, here's Cannon. She'll dump it out. It'll be an icing call because it's still 4-on-4. So a nice setup here on this draw for the Whitecaps. 14:08 remaining in the third. 4 seconds in the Danny Ray McInnes power play. Or penalty, pardon me. As Steve Ryan indicates to her to get in the play. Off the draw because they'll be on a power play. And here she comes. McNeil. McInnes couldn't keep it in. She wasn't at the box quickly enough off the deflection. McNeil. off the boards for McLean. Summer McLean now. McLean, wrist shot, glove save Williams. Rebound now, Flora Gale McNeil. She goes down, gets up gingerly. She's given it everything she's got in this tournament. A great performance all weekend. One of the shining stars for sure. There have been a lot of them. Whitecaps down low now, 45 seconds left of their power play. Here's Connolly. And off the point, Dwaron, it was redirected. And then steered wide by Williams. Oh, and down heavily was the Whitecap player. I think it was McEachern. Extra attacker on. Into the zone, McLean. Oh, nifty move, McLean, did she get hooked? So there are gonna be a pair of calls here, I think, against the Inferno. Richards. And it's blowing down. It may be two infractions here. Body contact. I thought there might be one on the Summer McLean play, but I think it's just one penalty. Mitchell for body contact. So another chance here in the power play for the Whitecaps as Flora Gale McNeil's having a chat with one of the referees. Now looks like Whitecaps timeout. Not sure what happened there. I don't know if Steve Ryan wanted one or what the situation was there. Or they were charged for one for slowing the progression. Nevertheless, the teams are talking it over now. 12:26 remaining in the third. 5-0 for the Inferno. Two goals for Danica Joseph, Leanna Cannon, Gabrielle London, and Molly McCarthy, all with one apiece. And that's where we stand at 5-0 here. So it looks like a penalty up on both sides. Not sure what the call against the Whitecaps is. But it's 5-on-4, at least players on the ice, so not sure what that 2 minutes is on the board for. I think it might be, now it's off. I think it might be a 10-minute misconduct, maybe. I don't even know about that, but it's still a Whitecap power play. McNeil. The charging call. Shot misses on the short side. Now McInnes, the Whitecap captain. Behind the net. Big penalty kill here for the Inferno. They don't want to give up any here either. McNeil. So strong on the puck. Great hands. And now she maneuvers, lays it there, trying to wrestle free was McLean. Now McLean with some room from the circle. Save the rebound. McNeil didn't get the wood on it. And then batted the rebound wide. McLean now. McLean draws a penalty against McCarthy. So it'll be 5-on-3 for 38 seconds. Face off will be the right of Lily Williams. Homecoming of sorts for Williams, just chatting with her grandmother between periods from the Sydney area. So lots of friends and family out to see her play for the Inferno. Shot, Williams, there she is. It's a hooking call against McCarthy. 10:52 remaining. McCormick out to take the draw. Back to the point. Dwarrell. Shot, Williams, the rebound. Sponicle couldn't get a stick on it. And a big play there. It's dumped out as the Inferno faithful get into it. Turnover. McCormick still with it. What great work by McCormick. Back to a 5-on-4. McCormick, what an effort. The captain leading the way for the Inferno. Sponigle trips. And now dumped out, now with 1 minute remaining in the second. Power play, chance here in front. Oh, a big save there by McKinnon in close quarters. Joseph didn't get much of a shot away, but still McKinnon turned away the sniper as she and Poirier get in there. Now McLean, Summer McLean, spinning from a check. Deflected away. Another good effort by Joseph, and then she gets spun around. The Inferno bench is incensed. And they score after that. And that's what the Inferno bench is angry about. Veronica McDonald with the goal. Or Violet, pardon me. At the 10:43 mark, McDonald on the power play to make it 5-1. So tough one there for the Inferno. Again, probably should have been a call against McLean for spinning around Poirier, or Joseph, pardon me. McInnes with the helper on the goal. 5-1, 8:50 remaining. So finally some results on those power plays for the Whitecaps. And don't forget the save by McKinnon in close on Joseph. Cutliff now. Cutliff. And over the blue line. She gets knocked down. Connolly now has it taken away. Cutliff a shot. And that hit a leg. Cormier couldn't get it deep. Williams with the save. Loose puck. She smothers it. With 7:59 remaining, we're gonna, I think, get a penalty call here against the Whitecaps. It was after the play, a slash. Olivia Morrell to the box, so a chance now and a big one for the Inferno with the advantage to get that goal back. And They're going to send out the firepower. London, Joseph, Cannon, Andrews on defense. Joined out there by Cormier. Wrist shot. McKinnon got a piece of it. And then it's dumped out. Cormier now. Richards harassing her, causes the turnover. Sean Richards centered it. And another penalty coming up. So it'll be 5-on-3. Leicester's possession, McKinnon, a big save on London. And it'll be 5-on-3 now, so a huge chance for the Inferno. So out is McCormick, Poirier, McCarthy. LaPierre on defense. Joined by Maren McNeil. LaPierre. LaPierre cross to McNeil. LaPierre into the high slot. McCormick. LaPierre. Lots of traffic in front of Tessa McKinnon. McCormick now, shot! And an arm saved by McKinnon. Trying to pin it as McInnes comes free. And now McCormick after it. And ripped out. McNeil couldn't keep it in, now LaPierre. 5-on-3, the Inferno. Trying to make the push for some more goals here. And over the blue line, Cannon. Wrist shot, she scores through a screen. Leanna Cannon, her second of the night. At the 13:50 mark. Similar to the one that Joseph scored to open the game. On the power play, Cannon. To make it 6-1, still on the power play with 6:10 remaining. And now Morrell dumps it out. Green back after it. She's going to be chased. Green. Away from the checker, Green. Upended. Inferno bench looking for another call. Joseph dropped it off for Leanna Cannon. Joseph and London, the helpers. What a game for that trio. Knockdown, Green and Mitchell back for it. Final seconds of the Richards penalty. Inferno have to push the offense here. Mitchell back to get it. Mitchell getting cranked up. Sinclair White couldn't control it. And now Sinclair White. She'll want to get it in deep. McKinnon smothers it for a face-off with 4:56 remaining. We'll face off to the right of McKinnon. McKinnon, oh, they score! McKinnon juggled it. .452 remaining. By the reaction of the fans in the bench, That may be the golden goal as far as differential here. Poirier at 15:03. McCormick with the assist at the 15:08 mark to make it 7-1. Again, unsure. I'm just surmising on the reaction of the crowd in the bench that that might be again a 6-goal difference. McLean and Williams, that might be her best of the night considering the time and situation. I don't know how she saw it through a sea of bodies. 4:33 remaining. White Caps looking to spoil the party here for the Inferno. And I'm just thinking of the reaction as well. If that was a goal to go up 7-1, you wouldn't have the celebration that you saw from the Inferno in a lopsided game. But if it's your team trying to get to a provincial championship, it's understandable. Less than 4 minutes remaining. Cormier. Spinning away from Richards. Connolly from the point, saved by Williams. McNeil trying to barge in front. Flora Gale still has it, and she's upended. Wow, McNeil has gotten a rough ride in this one. That's a couple of times she's been hauled down, and she gingerly heads to the bench. What a great tournament for her. She gets a pat on the back as she heads to the bench. She created this power play opportunity. Five on four. Lily Williams on the spot. Ripped around the boards. McInnes. It's McCormick, the captain, for tripping. It's so tough against Flora Gale. McNeil, the size, strength, skill. When she gets that puck, it's hard to dislodge it from her without getting a penalty. Fight Frances McDonald now. What a important power play for the Whitecaps. And more so penalty kill for the Inferno. As Williams smothers it. 2:44 remaining, 1:25 in the power play. Back to the point. Dwarrell gets it back. Dwarrell. Fight Frances McDonald after it. Sponigal looking in front, got knocked away. On the pinch. Sponigal now. Centered it. Put back to the point. That shot knocked down by London. Still 45 seconds remaining in the power play. Fight Frances McDonald couldn't get a shot away. Chance to dump it out here by the Inferno. Getting it back is Cleary. That deflects. Battle down low. Spun around the boards. Fight Francis McDonald now, 1:30 remaining. Sharp angle and a save by Williams. With 8 seconds remaining in the power play. Seven to one for the Inferno again with the victory. They will be 2-1-1. Which puts them in a tie with the Metro West Force Warriors. And again, by the reaction of the Inferno on that seventh goal, you wouldn't see that in a meaningless game, so they must have their calculations going as well on who will win a tiebreaker. The two teams tied yesterday in round robin play 3-3. And that shot just missed. McLean now. Summer McLean. McCormick. Telling McCormick to get over the red line, dump it in. So it's protection mode now. So this must be the margin they need. We'll definitely find out by the reaction. Because again, if the win doesn't mean a spot in the championship game, there wouldn't be such a celebration. But now, all alone in front, but Fight Francis McDonald didn't see. She's still with it. And again, we're not sure the reaction here was. I thought we might see more excitement. I'm not sure if the Inferno needed more. Maybe we'll find out before we leave the air here. So a big win, a convincing one for the Inferno. Whitecaps finish at 1-3. I think that might be what the teams are discussing as the handshake line starts. Led by Flora Gail McNeil, what a tournament she had. 5 goals in 4 games. And a great effort. As now the players shake hands with the coaches as well. Great performance offensively, and now we'll wait for the Player of the Game awards. Plenty of choices for the Inferno. And we'll see who the selections are. Again, our round robin portion wrapped up now. 10 showcases of female hockey that can make the province proud. And it'll culminate again tomorrow at 11. Violet McDonald, the player of the game. She had the lone white cap goal.
Player of the game for the Metro East Inferno, number 3, Leanna Cannon.
Leanna Cannon, who had a pair. That line of Cannon. Joseph. And London was sensational. So again, folks, that'll do it here for the Member Toon Sport and Wellness Center. And the Inferno, I think, are discussing things here and now as they thank their fans. And again, they win their final round robin game, a 7-1 victory. And that'll wrap up day two of the tournament here in Member Two, but it's not over yet. Tomorrow, 11 a.m., if you can't make it out to the rink, we'll have all the action for you here on the Member Two Hockey YouTube page. So again, the final score, the Metro East Inferno 7, the Quad County Whitecaps 1. For Nolan Jessup behind the camera, I'm Corey LeBlanc. Good night from Member Two and the 2024 Nova Scotia Under-15 AAA Female Hockey Championship.